Well, the FBI reports a recent rise in hate crimes in the United States. And now, as Mike Hsu explained, several groups in Howard County have gotten together to try and do something about it.
You don't have to look very far to find a hate crime. In May, at this mosque in Silver Spring, a note in the mailbox offering a bounty for slaughtered Muslims. A year earlier in Glen Elg, four teens are convicted for tagging their school with hate crime graffiti. But what is to be done?
And you'll have the courage to step in.
In Howard County, the Council on American-Islamic Relations is educating a capacity crowd on how to intervene when a hate crime is happening.
So our goal is to empower our communities to be able to safely intervene so that when something does happen and they witness it, they're able to safely de-escalate the situation and help the people who are the target of these kind of incidents.
This isn't a history lesson. The people here are looking for answers.
And how I can even use those skills tonight that I learned and apply that like when I go back to campus or just in my day-to-day life as well.
And interestingly enough, intervention does not mean engaging the person making the threats.
And our philosophy is that you only talk to the person who's being targeted. You don't talk to the person who's the harasser, because we want to de-escalate what we're doing today.
Organizers say many people have the goodwill to intervene, but they just don't know what to do.
We as a society have a choice. We can either stay quiet and accept that as a status quo, or we can resist that. And doing these kind of trainings is one form of resistance.
I'm Mike Hsu reporting for WJZ.